Ostavniosis, Wikipedia Audio. Ostavniosis, IAST, Ostavinyasa are a set of yoga vinyasas which primarily involve movement of the arms. The Ostavinyasas are Parsvabhaga, Purvabhaga, Prasarana, elbow movement, hands on shoulder blades movements, hands lock behind movements, Prishtanjali, and shoulder rotations. Ostavinyasa is Sanskrit, Asta Sanskrit, an adjective meaning formed with the hands, and Vinyasa Sanskrit, meaning movement. Etymology. Below is a table describing of the etymology behind each of the Ostavinyasas. All non-English words in this table are Sanskrit. As vinyasas which have Tadasana as their base, the Ostavinyasas improve balance, and calm the mind and ready a practitioner for asana practice. Simultaneously the movement of the Ostavinyasas help invigorate the body and prepare it for other asana practice. When performing these vinyasas, all bandhas may be engaged, except in the backward bending vinyasas, where Jalandhara bandha is not fully engaged. Additionally, pranayama is of utmost importance during vinyasa practice. Breath and movement should be coordinated appropriately. The starting position for Parsvabhaga vinyasa is Samasthiti. While inhaling, stretch the arms straight to the sides and over the head, ending the inhale with the fingers interlaced and palms facing upward. As the palms are being turned out, the arms should be pulled upwards. After remaining in the stretch with the arms above the head for a moment, with the exhale, the hands are then brought out along sides back to Samasthiti. The length of the upwards and downwards actions should be equal and long. It can be practiced a few times, stretching more each time. Parsvabhaga vinyasa primarily stretches the sides and the chest muscles. This movement provides a healthy stretch to thoracic cavity and rib structures, especially with a slight back bend. Like Purvabhaga vinyasa begins in Samasthiti, but the hands are turned so the palms face backwards. As in Parsvabhaga vinyasa, the arms are raised slow with the inhale. At the peak, the palms face forward. The breath may be held for a moment, before lowering the arms with the exhale, both breath and movement finishing simultaneously. This vinyasa can be performed a few times, progressively deepening the stretch. From a standing position with the arms crossed, palms on opposite thighs, swing the arms slowly out and up to shoulder height on their respective sides, hold for a moment, and return the hands. The movement, as with Parsvabhaga vinyasa and Purvabhaga vinyasa, is done inhaling up and exhaling down, the motions beginning and ending with their appropriate breath. It can also be repeated a few times. Prasara, a vinyasa is a good chest opener, especially when breathing deeply. The elbow movement involves interlocking the fingers behind the base of the head, with the arms raised and out to the sides. From standing, the arms are first raised above the head on the inhale, and then lowered on the exhale to their place behind the head, with the chest open and shoulder blades adducted. There is then a pause, and the hands are raised again while inhaling, and returned slowly to the sides with the exhale. This position should not be forced if the practitioner exhibits stiffness. The elbow movement can be repeated a few times before returning the hands to the sides, but always with the breath. Especially with a slight back bend, this position expands the thoracic cavity, increasing lung capacity as well as stretching the intercostal muscles. There are two main hands on shoulder blades hand positions. one with the hands on their respective shoulder blades, and the other with the hands on their opposite shoulder blades. Both positions are entered in the same way. From samasthiti, on the inhale, the hands are raised over the head, as in Parsvabhaga Vinyasa, and with the exhale the elbows are bent and the hands are brought behind the back. The position is held for between 3 and 6 full breaths. To return to samasthiti, the arms are again raised on an inhale, and returned as in Parsvabhaga Vinyasa to the sides. Both movements open the chest, notably the pectoral muscles, and above the clavicles, and top area of the lungs. Description: these are two different positions, one with the hands interlaced palms down behind the body, and the other with the hands at the elbows behind the body. They can both be practiced with minor back bends. Both are entered in the same way. From samasthiti, raise the hands on an inhale as in Parsvabhaga Vinyasa, and lower with the exhale to the appropriate hand position. When exiting these positions, the hands are simply returned to the sides and not brought back up above the head. One hand clasps the elbow from the inside, and the other under the opposite bent elbow. When practiced as an Ostavinyasa, a minor backbend can be performed starting on an inhale after entering the pose. When backbending, the chest is lifted, shoulders dropped, and shoulder blades brought inward. There is then a pause with the breath held for a moment, and on the exhale one returns to standing. This backbending series is repeated 3-6 times. This hand position can also be applied to other asanas, such as Uttanasana, as well as backward bending poses. In the position, the fingers are interlaced with the palms facing downward, arms behind the back. A backbend is initiated on the inhale, with care taken to lift the chest up and bring the shoulders down. The posture is held for 3 to 6 breaths before returning with an exhale to a standing position. This position stretches the chest and facilitates back bending. When performing Passima Namaskara Vinyasa or P. Anjali, the arms are raised on an inhale, as in Parsvabhaga Vinyasa. On the exhale, they are brought, palms together to the bottom of the spine and slid upwards. All other aspects of the hand and arm position correspond with Passima Namaskarasana. A backbend can be added on the inhale in a similar fashion as with hands at elbows behind the body. After all, placing the hands on the elbows is considered a modification of Passima Namaskarasana. There are two Ostavinyasas for shoulder rotation. One is a backbend with hands over the head, followed by a simultaneous return to standing, and movement of the arms toward the front. The other is an arm movement lowering the arms and from above the head, and then opening horizontally to the sides. Beginning with the fingers interlaced above the head, a backbend is performed on the inhale. On the following exhale, the arms are brought around the sides to the front in an arc, ending palms up in front of the body. With the hands beginning above the head, palms facing forward, roughly shoulder width apart, the arms are lowered on an exhale to shoulder level. Parsvabhaga Vinyasa. Purvabhaga Vinyasa. The Ostavinyasas originate from Vinyasa Krama Yoga. Prasara, a Vinyasa. Elbow movement. Hands on shoulder blades movements. Hands lock behind body movements. Hands at elbows behind the body. Hands interlaced palms down. Reverse prayer Vinyasa. Shoulder rotation Vinyasas. Back bending shoulder rotation. Upright shoulder rotation. Style of yoga. Sources.